Ayanda Ncwane has proven to be an attraction since the start of Real Housewives of Durban. We visit her home, where she indulges us on everything. Since the broadcast of the Real Housewives of Durban, RHOD, music mogul Ayanda Ncwane, 36 years off, hasn't stopped trending. She trended religiously almost every Friday, when a new episode would be flighted on Showmax. People hadn't experienced the real Ayanda, but finally, they are getting to see my colorful personality, she gushes, as she sips tea in her lounge at one of the leafy Danefern Estates, a prestigious suburb in the north of Johannesburg. People would see me on social media and have perceptions of me. What they didn't know is that there are many dimensions to me. Although serious, I am also bubbly and fun. People have fallen in love with the well-put-together woman that I am, the mom of two smiles. In the first episode of Rod, Ayanda's Tuscan-style home oozes sophistication and class. She has gone for clean tons of white and beiges and says it was deliberate. Growing up, I lived in a home with dark colors, and when you walked out, you were greeted by goats and chickens, she laughs, adding that it is for this reason her home has these light colors. Ayanda was born in rural KwaZulu-Natal. Her home feels warm and there is no clutter, which makes it refreshing. Both the lounge and dining area open onto the indoor patio, which has a sliding door that leads to the pool and a manicured garden. The bedrooms are upstairs, and her room boasts an outdoor balcony arranged with outdoor furniture in case she doesn't want to go and relax downstairs. Her choice in furniture shows that she has a taste for the finer things in life. It's hard not to be struck by the eye-catching chandeliers hanging from the ceiling. Stunning property. Ayanda's Tuscan-style home oozes sophistication and class. She has gone for clean tones of white and beiges, and says it was deliberate. Growing up, I lived in a home with dark colors, and when you walked out, you were greeted by goats and chickens, she laughs, adding that it is for this reason her home has these light colors. Ayanda was born in rural KwaZulu-Natal. Her home feels warm and there is no clutter, which makes it refreshing. Both the lounge and dining area open onto the indoor patio, which has a sliding door that leads to the pool and a manicured garden. The bedrooms are upstairs, and her room boasts an outdoor balcony arranged with outdoor furniture in case she doesn't want to go and relax downstairs. Her choice in furniture shows that she has a taste for the finer things in life. It's hard not to be struck by the eye-catching chandeliers hanging from the ceiling. It's not every day that when a celebrity passes away, their wife continues to follow their joint dream and turn it into reality. FISO passed away suddenly in December 2016, and almost 5 years on, Ayanda has managed to keep his spirit alive. But she maintains, to some people, it might look as if I am continuing the legacy of my husband, but it is actually my family's empire and not FISO's legacy. In 2009, we decided we would start something that would continue from generation to generation with the same effort and same goal. She sets the record straight, even without him, the vision stands. It is not about an individual's legacy. Ayanda seems to be strong and doing well. But it has taken her time to come to this point of healing. We are fine. She sighs, referring to her two sons who are 16 and 12 years old. Honestly, we would be spitting in God's face if we were weak or fragile at this point. He has favored us enough to give us strength to continue on this journey. Brutal, hard, cold, wicked as it is, we have been able to withstand it. We are much stronger and doing well. Ayanda met FISO in 2002, when she was a waitress and had gone out for ice cream with colleagues on her day off. Within 5 minutes of us meeting, he said he would marry me. I laughed, but here I am today. I am Mrs. Ncwane, she laughs. Her husband's other child and baby mama. But things haven't always been rosy, as Ayanda admits she has faced some tribulations in her relationship. In the first episode of Rod, she came face to face, unknowingly, she claims, with the mother of FISO's other child. It was during a Diwali dinner at Sarisha Naidu's mansion with all the housewives, that Nanku Luleko Williams, known as Nanku, turned up as a companion to one of the housewives. During the dinner, it emerged that Nanku knew Ayanda very well, telling all and sundry that she had a child with Ayanda's late husband. Ayanda was shocked, she says, because she knew about the child and the mom, but had never met the woman before. Ayanda explains how this entire situation came about. In 2006, for about 8 months, FISO and I separated while we were dating. I was on a spiritual journey that entailed no sex. I got saved and I told him that he was either with me on this journey or not. He wasn't, so we went our separate ways, she says. Sviso didn't cheat. Even though Sviso and Ayanda's first child had already been born, they parted ways. It was during this time that Nanku fell pregnant with Sviso's child. People think Sviso cheated on me, but we were not together at the time. We were not even married. We only got married in June 2007, she says. Then they reconnected again. Sviso visited Ayanda's mother and grandmother and told them that, while they were on a break with Ayanda, he had fathered a child with someone else. They adored him and he was perfect in their eyes, so they sat us down and we reconciled. We went to church, but I was adamant that I was not going to engage in premarital sex. He repented, and months later, we got married, Ayanda recalls. She says Sviso's child with Nanku was never a secret. Nanku was married, and had left the child with her mom, and she and Sviso would often fetch the little girl from her grandmother's house to come and visit them. I knew Nanku's mom because our interaction was with her, but I had never met Nanku herself, she explains. While many women would be unforgiving at having their dirty laundry aired for all to see, Ayanda couldn't care less. Meeting Nanku in person and being able to talk like adults was God's plan. My stories have been shared the wrong way, so through this, I'm telling it live, she says, adding that it's God's plan to live this moment in the public eye. Not doing IT for TV. And her life is certainly public, with a spotlight on her as one of the housewives. She admits, never in a million years did I think I would do this. The casting director was smart. She approached me for months on end and persuaded me that the Durban installment needed women who are hardworking, in business, strong, independent, and inspirational. Based on the hardworking and inspirational factor, I was determined to do it so long as I didn't have to change who I am. I was clear about my conditions. I'm a Christian, I don't drink, and I will not be forced to drink for ratings. They reassured me in black and white, and here I am today. I'm one of the housewives. Wanting a baby. Ayanda is an open book and she shared on the reality show that she wants a baby before she is 40. I've been praying about it. Bab Ncwane and I had a name for our daughter, but unfortunately God took him before we could have the child. Through God's grace and God willing, I will have a baby before I am 40, as I don't want a huge gap between my children. So does this mean she is dating again after losing her husband? I have started looking at CVs, she laughs. In 2018 I started as sowing a seed and praying for a partner. God is preparing someone for me. When friends push me to start dating, I always tell them that I am in no hurry, she says. I took a vow that I would give myself 5 years to heal properly so that I don't compare my new partner to Sviso. Ayanda says she wants someone who will complement her intellect and everything she represents in business, and in the kingdom of God. I don't want someone who will take chances, she emphasizes, adding that she will not even describe the kind of qualities she wants in a man, just in case a sheep comes in wolf's clothing. I want to look at and identify those qualities myself and know that the person is genuine. I don't want people to come wearing these qualities to capture Ayanda, she says, hinting that she has a big crush on the president of Russia, Vladimir Putin. For now, she is a hard-working single mom who wants to give her children the best. Single mothers are powerful. I was raised by a single mom and grandmother, so becoming a single mom at a young age wasn't a train smash. I adapted easily. Family empire. While being on Rod might imply that Ayanda is a housewife, Ayanda works hard for her money and owns Ncwane Communications. I've always loved music, but I never thought I would go this far and be involved this much. My business focuses on empowerment and upliftment of musicians from the ground up. We also scout talent, do artist promotion and management, brand management of musicians, and host one of the biggest gospel festivals in SA, she says, adding that each year God favors them by opening our eyes to the opportunities that are available to empower not only our artists, but also those signed to other labels. She says their vision is to see musicians become independent, own their intellectual property and their music, and be aware of the copyright laws and so forth. What many people don't know is that Ayanda is the brains behind Abath & Dwa, a much-loved gospel group that became famous for Umoya Wham. Abath & Dwa have done well. The goal was not to expose them only to the South African market, we also wanted to grow them globally. In my research, I discovered that if we positioned them just for the South African market, their lifespan would be short. So, we recorded them, created a footprint in South Africa, and then immediately took them out. We started traveling around Africa, and they became known. But, honestly, since last year we haven't been working due to COVID-19. We are putting plans together for the global stages we initially planned, she continues. True love.